the world's sort of most renowned, most wanted criminal, mysteriously turns himself in for reasons unknown and offers to help the FBI go out and catch all of the people whom he has worked with over the past 20 years. All of his known associates, but will only do so if they allow him to work with an agent who he, you know, he sort of seemingly has no connection with. Elizabeth Keene is played by Megan Boone, and the story opens on her first day as a profiler at the FBI. It is also the day, coincidentally or perhaps not, that Raymond Reddington has surrendered himself, and this is the only agent who he will speak with. And Elizabeth is a very relatable sort of everywoman. She's not necessarily out kicking down doors and wielding guns, although there's a lot of action in the show. To me, this really is sort of Liz's show. It's about a woman who is chosen. It's a chosen one story, and it's going to be very interesting seeing her journey of sort of self-discovery of why was she chosen by this man, what is her potential connection with him, and what secrets are in her life that she doesn't even know of herself. I mean, things from her past. So anyway, this is a woman. Elizabeth is a woman who is carrying tremendous secrets with her. The entire concept of The Blacklist is built around this relationship between Reddington and Elizabeth. Why her? Why now? How is she chosen? What in her past may be relevant now? And what in her past may she not know about herself? There's very much a sort of back and forth, a cat and mouse that's going on between these two. And as much as Reddington is powerful and sort of has the FBI by the short hairs, she has Reddington because he will only speak to Elizabeth Keene. And so there's something within her that makes Reddington, there's something within Elizabeth that makes Reddington rather vulnerable. James Spader brings a whole sort of different dynamic to the character. As an actor, he's very specific, he's very articulate, he's a very smart guy, and that only elevates the character, you know? I mean, this is written as a man who is an expert in languages and coding and intelligence. He's immersed himself in the world of U.S. and global intelligence, and to have somebody like Spader playing this role, I mean, it's fantastic. He has become this character. He has become Raymond Reddington, and it's a new look. We haven't seen this James Spader. I can promise you that. The Blacklist is certainly not a show that is set solely within the walls of the FBI. What's interesting to me is going out into the real world and into various worlds of crime, whether it's Wall Street or counterfeiting or espionage, whatever it may be. We want to go out to great locations, you know, to really have, the show has a sense of, sort of a global perspective on the world, you know, sort of a global, at least on the criminal world, you know. And so we want to go out and from week to week explore these different cultures and crimes, you know. Yeah.